Hello, I'm Dr. Lee. Welcome to Practical Pain Management. I'll talk about discogenic pain. It is a part two. I'd appreciate if you could turn on English caption for better communication. Provocative discography is the only confirmative diagnostic tool of a painful disc so far. What do I need for provocative discogram? Spinal needles, connecting tube, manual or automated disc manometry, non-ionic contrast media. Here are the primary procedure steps and mechanism. After putting the needle in the nucleus pulposus, connect the tube between the spinal needle to disco manometry. Fill in the contrast media in the injection pump, and then initiate the injection pump. The intra-syringe pressure transfers to connecting tube and is relayed to spinal needle. Contrast media fill in the disc and slowly increase the intradiscal pressure. We measure the intra-syringe pressure. Because we cannot measure the intradiscal pressure directly. Let's look at the intradiscal process in more details. Continuous infusion of contrast media will fill in the disc and increase the intradiscal pressure gradually. Expands, expands, and expands. The contrast media distend the annular fibrosis and invade the annular tail area. It invades more the torn area. It irritates the wound and provokes pain. During the procedure, one of my team communicates with the patient, continuously checking the pain responses. We can confirm the discogenic pain when the patient feels the concordant pain. By this method, we can confirm the discogenic pain so far. In addition to pain evaluation during the provocative discogram, we evaluate the torn annular morphology. According to discogram, the annular tear can be classified into five types. Grade 0, it is a normal, there is no tearing of annular fibrosis. Grade 1, a small annular tear extends from the nucleus radially into the inner one-third of annular fibrosis. Grade 2, annular tear has grown larger and is within the middle one-third of the annulus. Grade 3 and 4, the annular tear has completely ripped through the annular fibrosis. Grade 5, the contrast media is leaking through the annular defect out into the epidural space. This content will migrate via annular defect, irritating nerve root or dorsal root ganglion. We have reviewed the provocative discogram and basic principles. Studying its mechanism is useful to understand discogenic pain. But there are some limitations and flaws. Neurosurgeon is looking for candidate for lumbar disc operation. They are afraid of post-surgical pain syndrome. There are individual variations of pain threshold. In chronic pain patients, the pain threshold is decreased compared to ordinary people. They even feel severe pain in slightly increased intradiscal pressure. We possibly misdiagnose these people as discogenic pain. The incision or artificial tissue damage will be a new pain generator. I reviewed persistence post-surgical pain in the previous video. Persistence chronic pain was reported from 10 to 50% of individuals after common operation. In chronic pain patients, these numbers would surge than the average group. These patients would complain of more pain after incision or operation. Furthermore, according to many researches, provocative discogram was reported to have a high rate of false positive results. With the age process, the annular tear advances and worse, and it is a natural course of all humanity. Most people do not complain of pain in their daily activities. Artificial increment of intradiscal pressure could provoke pain in the disrupted annulus. To make it worse, it may be possible that the pressurized contrast media push out the disc content through the annular defect. I had a painful experience in the past. I have been talking about false positive findings of a provocative discogram and one adverse effect. But how about the false negative result?